Hi, I'm Sam with JBugs.com. With the engine from our 1971 Volkswagen Type 3 Squareback pulled out, it's time to tear it down to the long box so we can diagnose the issue and repair the engine. Immediately, we can see the first error that may have caused some of the problem. As we've mentioned before, the original fuel injection, stock muffler, and heater boxes have been replaced with dual carbs, a header system, and J-tubes. The heater ducts from the fan shroud were not blocked off when the heater boxes were removed. This caused the engine to overheat, as the air will follow the path of least resistance. Instead of the air being pushed through the cylinder's heads and oil cooler, most of it was leaving through the ducts and not cooling the engine. We start the disassembly by removing the nuts at both the J-tubes, loosening the header clamps, and removing the J-tubes. The header nuts at both heads are removed, so we can pull off the header and muffler assembly. Next, the carburetors and linkage can be pulled off by unthreading the nuts at the intake manifolds at both heads. And when the left or 3/4 side carb off, we can see a problem with the number 3 cylinder. The intake tract is covered in carbon, which means the intake valve has been opened, allowing exhaust gases to build up on the intake. Continuing with the teardown, we remove the coil, followed by the engine intake cover bolts. The generator belt is worn, so we cut it and remove the intake cover. The generator strap is unbolted, so the generator can be removed. The distributor clamp nut is pulled off the engine case, and the distributor and clamp are pulled out. The multiple sheet metal screws are removed from the cylinder shroud so they can be pulled off, and now the oil cooler can be removed. Next, a flywheel lock is bolted to the case, and the crank pulley nut is removed, so the crank pulley can be pulled off. The coil bracket and front fan shroud bolts can be unbolted, so the front fan shroud cover can be removed. A pulley puller is used to pull off the crankshaft fan, and the rear fan shroud can be unbolted from the oil filler tower and engine. The left and right cylinder deflect tins can be pulled off, and the rear engine cross brace can be unbolted from the engine case. The oil filler tower is unbolted from the case and pulled up while the breather tube is pulled off the dipstick tube. And with that, all the engine tin accessories are removed. In our next video, we'll get the engine mounted to a stand so we can get off the ground, and we'll pull the cylinder heads and see what needs to be done to get the engine running, back in the car, and back on the road again. Thanks for watching, and remember to stop by JBugs.com the next time you need parts or accessories for your vintage VW.